Come on. Come on, let's look everywhere. She must be here, I'm certain. Keep looking. We mustn't give up. Adele, that little girl has been standing motionless in front of the kitchen door for hours. Poor thing, I gave her some candy. She ate it without a word and remained motionless. I don't think she's very well. We used to see her now and again, but now she's always there. I'm going. The doctor's not here. He's coming this afternoon. Try and speak to him. Poor thing. Lost in her dreams. She was only a little girl. But nobody gave her a cuddle. They punished her instead. They said she was sick and her dreams were troubling her. They weren't even hers anymore. I need her. But we will find her. We'll find her, won't we? When the water in the shower was cold, we ran away. But when it was hot, then she came to Renee under that cruel white light. I can still feel the shivers her body gave me. Everything must return to how it was. If we recreate that magic, she'll come to us. We have to turn the water on in the showers and switch the boiler on. All the plumbing systems were in the kitchen area. Now everything is ready. We can go to the bathrooms. We can go along that narrow corridor in the kitchens. We'll meet her in the showers, yes. Now everything is ready. We can go to the bathrooms. We can go along that narrow corridor in the kitchens. We'll meet her in the showers, yes. Everything's ready. Let's get undressed and leave our clothes on the hooks in the changing rooms. Let's turn the water on now, and everything will be as before. Amara was everything I could have been, but she no longer existed. I'd have loved to erase everything I did, but instead I always went ahead and did it again. It was my fault, and she disappeared from my life. They gave you injections there, which made your body and soul tremble violently. A whirlwind of anguish and unbearable pain. I lived in terror of the next time, They had taken me upstairs to that ward where no one wanted to go. Let's look for Renee's room in the slightly agitated ward. When there was too much chaos, they closed all the windows and the door. They turned off the lights, and it was pitch black. Some people fell asleep. Some others stopped seeing their demons and became more calm. She wouldn't stop pleasuring herself. I can still hear her death rattle. I screamed, but nobody came. Everybody screamed in there, all of them. It was then I saw the doll, which wasn't Charlotte. No, she wasn't Charlotte. To hurt me again, in the loneliness of that crowded ward. He brought it with him. I thought I would never see him again. He'd come to remind me who I was. That's what my mother used to do. That's what I had done. It seems that my life in here was just a repeat of what it had been outside. The doll. The fear. The shame. I'd have loved to erase everything I did, but instead I always went ahead and did it again.
No. Montefoscoli, November 12th, 1939.
My dear daughter, it is with great sadness that I heard what happened. Your transfer and your sufferings are a cause of great worry for me. It will take time, but you'll see, things will improve. They'll treat you and you'll get better again. I pray a lot, every day. Write to me often and tell me if you need anything. I promise I'll do what I can. Try to be strong. Mom. This is the last letter she wrote to me. Once I was put into this ward, I was overwhelmed by loneliness. After that medical examination, I received no more letters from Mom. Why is that man here? Why doesn't she come to see me? Did I make a mistake? It didn't seem like she wanted to abandon me. What did I do wrong? I'd like to be able to reply to her again now, to change things. Perhaps she would have listened to me. Will she reply? The letters were sent to the archive. It was their job to post them.
When you were sent to a lunatic asylum, you lost the right to possess anything. Everything you arrived with was packed up and stored here, even the clothes you were wearing. In case you were released one day, but far too many never left. There must be a file with my name in the filing cabinet somewhere. Dear Mother, please, I beg you, get me out of this place. I'm so frightened here. You were right. I know I was wrong. I understand. I'm so ashamed. If only you knew how much. But now I'll behave myself, I promise. Now things will be fine. I'll work hard. I'll be very good. Your daughter, Renee. This letter, it was Renee's letter, just as she wrote it back then, but it was never sent. Why? Why did this happen?
I received your letter, Mom. You tell me to be patient and strong, while I only feel fear and pain.
And you don't write to me anymore. If only these words could be my soul. I'd tell you what was happening to me.